हरे कृष्णा। वी ऑल नो द स्टोरी ऑफ गजेंद्र, दिस कम्स इन द पेजेस ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम। गजेंद्र वॉज द किंग ऑफ एलिफेंट्स, ही हैड अ ग्रेट फॉलोइंग, ग्रेट नंबर ऑफ वाइव्स, फैन फॉलोइंग, चिल्ड्रन। एंड गजेंद्र वन डे, द भागवतम एक्सप्लेन्स, ही गोज टू अ ब्यूटिफुल लेक टू टेक अ बाथ, अ वेरी प्रिस्टीन क्लियर लेक। ही इज गोइंग देयर फॉर अ पिकनिक अलॉन्ग विद हिज एंटायर फैमिली। But Gajendra didn't know that underneath the waters was a crocodile. And as soon as Gajendra entered this water, the crocodile comes and holds the leg of Gajendra. And Gajendra turns to his family, to his friends, but no one comes to help him. That time Gajendra realizes the nature of this world. What Gajendra thought was a picnic turned out to be his greatest nightmare. So this world is a place where there is danger at every step. Padam padam yad vipadam na tesham. At every step there is danger. Radhanath Swami Maharaj, one of a great leader in ISKCON, was giving a class. And at the end of the class, one of his disciple, Anand Vrindavan Prabhu, asked Maharaj a question. He asked Maharaj this question, that when I work in the Bombay Stock Exchange, so Anand Vrindavan Prabhu works in the Bombay Stock Exchange. So he explained that one day there was a bomb explosion in the stock exchange, and on that day he literally cried out the names of Krishna, he cried out the names of God. So his question to Radhanath Swami was, I don't feel that same urgency when I chant every day. So Maharaj told him, remember that incident of the bomb that occurred in that Bombay stock exchange and know that Maya has bombs everywhere. That is why this place is called Bombay, a bay where there are bombs. So the nature of this world is, at which step danger is going to come, there is no guarantee. Srila Prabhupada one time was walking in the building of our Mayapur complex, and on top of this building there was a snake that came there. And Srila Prabhupada looked at his disciples and told them, what does this indicate? Whoever imagined that a snake could come on the roof of her building? So this proves that danger or death can come at any moment. That is the nature of this world. Radhanath Swami Maharaj mentions in his journey home another very interesting anecdote. When he was hitchhiking all the way from America to India, he had to cross Greek and then come to Turkey. So as they were crossing this border, they had to walk in an area called a no man's land. This was a dead area. And there were rumors that there were landmines in this area. During the Greek Civil War, there were landmines that were implanted there. And at any step, any of these landmines could explode. So that is the nature of this world. At which step danger will come, there is no guarantee. Nishwase nahi vishwasa, kada rudo bhavishyati, kirtaniya mato balyad, harer namaiva kevalam. Nishwase nahi vishwasa. When the last breath is going to be, there is no guarantee. Therefore, as soon as we understand the urgency of this world, the dangerous situation of this world, we should take up to spiritual life with great urgency. This is something that's very important. So Gajendra, what does he do? When he is caught in this mouth of the crocodile, he tries to struggle it hard by himself, but he realizes that he is getting powerless and the crocodile is winning. So that time, Gajendra does something that is very intelligent. Gajendra picks up a lotus flower that was there in that very same pond and offers it to the Supreme Lord with his heartfelt prayer. And the Supreme Lord comes to save Gajendra. So therefore, in all our difficulties in this world, in all the problems that in this world that keep coming at any moment, the only solution that will work is we need to cry out to that Supreme Lord. So therefore Bhagavatam says, Samashritaye pada pallava plavam mahat padam punya yasho murare bhavam budhir vatsa padam param padam 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 yad vipadam na tesham. So the Bhagavatam says that this world is a place where there is danger at every step. So how can we overcome it? When we take shelter of that Supreme Lord, this world, which is a huge ocean filled with danger, becomes as small as a water in a hoof print of a calf. The entire ocean, Kaler Doshan Ide Rajan, the entire ocean filled with all the problems of this world reduces to that much of water in a hoofprint of a calf, and anyone can cross it. Even a child can cross it. So how does this become when someone surrenders to that Supreme Lord and offers prayers? That's why in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Devi hesha gunamai mama maya duratyaya mameva prapadyante mayam etam tarantite. So Lord Krishna tells in the Gita that this material nature, which is filled with too many problems, is very difficult to overcome. Duratyaya. But how we can overcome it? Mameva prapadyante. When we surrender to that Supreme Lord, then we can overcome this ocean of problems. So therefore, the ultimate solution to overcome all our problems and to get rid of this dangerous situation is to surrender to that Lord. And how do we do it? When we fall on our feet, on our knees, and offer our heartfelt prayers to the Lord. Anand Vrindavan Prabhu another time asked Maharaj another question, that when I chant Hare Krishna, before I begin to focus on my chanting and offer my prayers to the Lord, one problem comes. As I try to solve that problem, another problem comes. As I try to solve that problem, the third problem comes. So many problems come. I just can't chant Hare Krishna. I just can't surrender to the Lord. So Radhanath Swami Maharaj gave an amazing reply. He told him, that means your problems are not enough. That means you don't have sufficient problems. When you have sufficient problems, you will not analyze. You will just fall on your knees and offer your prayers to the Lord. And that is the time Lord will advent. Just like He advented for Gajendra, just like the Lord advented to save Draupadi. Similarly, the Lord will advent in our life, provided we fall on our knees and offer our prayers to the Lord. To the people of this world, we may send an email, isn't it? You send an email to communicate with the people of this world. But to communicate to God, email doesn't work. What works is knee mail. You have to fall on your knees and offer prayer. Whether the people of this world read our emails and reply to our emails, there is no guarantee. But God will definitely read and reply to all our heartfelt prayers, because God answers knee mails. Hare Krishna.